After we conclude the session, two people will get a chance to hear Dr. Zakir. If you want to hear the answer, and those who want to hear can stay back, others can go. Yes, Mr. Bade.
Hari Om to Hindus, Jai Jinendra to Jains, Salam Walekum to Muslim Bhai.
Walekum Assalam.
A request to Dr. Zakir, I have all the answers of all your 20 questions, but that will not allow. Kindly give me a chance. Any time you will get the logical answers of all the 20 questions, number one. Now, all the religions they follow the God is Almighty. Now, that means one should follow His rules also. Now, what is given by the God, the rules formed up by the God? Ek seedhi si baat hai, ki jab Bhagwan ne hame janam diya hai, to unhone humare liye kuch vyavastha bhi ki hai.
I would apply the same rule I applied to the last speaker. 1 minute. Put your question in 5 sentences. Assume Dr. Zakir and Mr. Zaveri know the background. Ask your question. Six sentences, please.
I am asking you the question only. तो भगवान ने हमारे लिए जो भी कुछ दिया है उन्होंने कुछ रूल फॉर्म करके दिए हैं, जैसे कि हमारे लिए सबसे एसेंशियल बात है हवा की. प्लेंटी ऑफ हवा इज अवेलेबल, अबंडेंट हवा इज अवेलेबल. उसके बाद पानी रहता है, पानी वेयर एवर यू गो पानी इज अवेलेबल. नाउ अदर थिंग इज फूड, व्हिच आई एम कमिंग टू द क्वेश्चन. द फूड भगवान हैज गिवन अस द फूड ऑल्सो. काश्मीर में है, हमारे लिए काश्मीर में है, इलाके के मुताबिक दिया है. काश्मीर में है हमारे लिए आलमंड्स दिए है, काजू दिए है, बादाम दिए है, पिस्ते दिए है, जहाँ के वहाँ जरूरी है. वन सेकंड. राजस्थान में जाओ आपको वहाँ वो टेम्परेचर के मुताबिक आपको खरबूजा मिलेगा, तरबूजा मिलेगा. यहाँ हमारे लिए वन सेकंड क्वेश्चन आई एम टेलिंग यू. यहाँ हमारे लिए हलवा बना के केले पे ऊपर रख दिया, और व्हाट एवर इजीली इज अवेलेबल ही हैज गिवन इज प्लेंटी. नाउ व्हाट एवर ही हैज गिवन इज प्लेंटी इज चीपर, एंड व्हाट एवर ही सेज नो इट इज नॉट टू बी टेकन और इट इज रिस्ट्रिक्टेड शुड बी he has made it costly. So are we following the rule of the God?
Sir, what very is your question good. On this topic?
Very
he
good.
Has understood it.
Okay. Very, I've understood the question. Very long question. Very good question. See, I'm in the field, I can make out the question, I'm in the field. Regarding the first part, that you can answer all 20 points, I've got various students in this field. I'll ask one of my students to have a dialogue at IRF. If you want, anytime, which date? Next Sunday. Next Sunday. Not me, my student. Next Sunday.
I can answer to anybody.
Next Sunday.
Anybody.
Next Sunday.
Anybody.
Okay, no. Done. Next Sunday you're invited. What's your name? Brother, your name?
Everything will be given.
Mr. Bade will come to IRF at 10:30. Fine. 10:30 morning. Sunday. Same format here, and my student will debate. Anyone. Same topic. His question, that God has provided air, right, water, everything easily available. So why go for things which are uneasily available and costly? Very good question. That you have to point out to Mr. Zaveri. He's telling that vegetables should be transported to Arctic Circle. Vegetables should be transported to deserts. Tell him, I didn't say that. I'm saying if vegetable is available, have vegetable. If animal is available, have the lawful animal. You have to pose that question to him, not to me. Point number one. You should have easily available food as long as it is lawful. We should have expensive food, you told me. It's like I telling a rich person, why are you living in Nariman Point? You know, 1 square feet of land, apartment, Nariman Point, costs 25,000 rupees. Come to Mira Road, only 1,000 rupees per square feet. When the rich man can afford to pay money to buy a good flat, why are you preventing a rich man to buy good food? And non-veg food, in protein, in iron, in various ways, medically, it is superior, it's of higher quality. So if rich man can afford it, why are you stopping? If you can't afford, have vegetables. I'm not stopping you. Hope that answers the question.